Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This lecture is designed only and specifically for AS students, AS accounting students. The topic is cost and management accounting. About cost, everyone knows about it. In business, the cost is used for the value of the goods and services produced or purchased available for sale. So all the values and the prices are accumulated till the goods are available for sale. For the trading business, the cost is the cost of goods purchased and the transportation cost, import duties, and it is a wider term to be used in the manufacturing concern. So when we are manufacturing any goods, or the manufacturer has to incur so many costs in the factory, so all the costs incurred, like direct material, indirect material, and all the other expenses incurred in the factory called factory overheads, it is to be accumulated. It is called cost of goods manufactured. The cost and management, like management refers to the decision making process of the company or a business. So many decisions are to be taken appropriately to have the to obtain the objective of maximization of profit. Certain managements are there, like human resources, production management, sale management, and financial management, and also likewisely the cost management. So when we are taking decisions about the cost, selling price, and the other quick decisions or future planning about the cost, it is covered by the topic cost and management accounting. To understand the concept of cost and management accounting, the beginnings are to learn the concept, basic concept of cost. Like first of all, we can divide the cost into two concepts, period cost and the product cost. Product cost refers to the production cost or purchase cost. For the trading business, it is purchase cost, the cost of goods purchased, added values like transportation, import duty, etc., etc. And for the manufacturing concern, it includes direct material cost, direct labor cost, and other variable manufacturing costs, and finally the factory or manufacturing overheads. So accumulation of all these costs will give you the product cost or the period cost, product cost. All other costs incurred in the after the factory cost, like selling expenses, administration expenses, distribution expenses, which are to be incurred to sell the goods, selling expenses, all these costs are the period cost. So after bifurcation of the cost, we have to go ahead the production cost. In the production cost, especially the first cost is direct material cost. So direct material is the cost of the material which is incurred in a production, which is identifiable, and direct labor cost is the cost of the product paid to the persons or employees or the workers or the operators or the machine operators who are directly involved in the production. And other variable expenses like likewise we have to incur, and in the factory all other expenses to be incurred in the factory like supervisor salary, manager salary, super salary, and it is called indirect labor, and other material to be used over there which is not identifiable in the production, it is called indirect material, lighting expenses, heating expenses, insurance of the building, insurance of the machinery, all those expenses are to be incurred in the factory to complete the product. These are included in the factory overhead. So all these costs are the product cost or the period cost, and other than the cost is called period cost, this is the production cost or the product cost, and this is the period cost. Thank you.